Hi everyone, we're back for another video in the Shopify app CLI series. In this video, we're going to create a Rails app and talk about the different steps involved in this process. If you haven't installed the app CLI tool yet, make sure you check out the video in the description below that will show you the installation process and running basic commands. Before you get started, you'll also need to ensure you have the latest version of Ruby installed, as well as Yarn. Once you've got the app CLI tool set up on your computer and you're ready to start building an app with Rails, navigate to a good place to store your app. For me, it'll be a generic project folder called My Projects, and then I will run Shopify Create to create my app. And today we're building a Ruby on Rails app, so I will choose that, and I will call my app Rails app. Now we get to choose whether we want to build a public or a custom app. A public app is an app built for a wide merchant audience versus a custom app, which is built for a single client. Today, I'll choose public app, and the CLI has generated a URL to authenticate me with my Shopify Partners account. So I will copy this, paste it into my browser, then I will log into my partner account, and now I'm authenticated successfully. So now I get to choose which development store I would want to install my Rails app on, and I will choose the first one. And now I get to choose which database type to use. So the default is SQLite, and you can change this now or later, but for now I will stick with SQLite, so I won't change the default. And now it's installing Rails and bundler gems. So now it's all done. I can also navigate to the app within Partner Dashboard. So if I copy that URL and then go here, I can see that the app has been associated with my partner account and it has all of the normal things that are associated with an app. So if I navigate to my project folder, then I run Shopify Serve to start my server. So you'll see that the CLI uses a third-party tunneling tool called ngrok, and you can learn more about it at the link below. But for now, we can use the URL that was provided, and I will choose to update my application URL with it. So I'll choose yes, and now my server is starting. And if I go back to Partner Dashboard to my Rails app setup page, if I refresh this, we'll see that the app URL was updated to the ngrok tunnel. So going back here, the CLI has generated an install link for me for my app on my development store. So I will copy that. If I go back here, first I will just log into my development store. It's this one. And then I will copy and paste the install link. And you can see my OAuth install page here for my Rails app on my development store. And I will choose install app. And you'll see my app is now installed. So success. Thanks for joining us so far. If you found this video helpful, make sure you like and subscribe to our channel. We upload helpful videos every week to support you with your development work on Shopify. And remember to check out the links in the description box for more helpful resources. Thanks for watching.